My name is Michael Gubbins, and I'm the Chief Bureau Officer of the Criminal Assets Bureau here at Walter Scott House. As you may be aware, the Bureau is an independent statutory agency comprised of members of Garda Síochána, officials from their Office of Revenue Commissioners, Customs and Taxes, officials from the Department of Social Protection, together with staff from the Department of Justice, including the Bureau Legal Officer, Forensic Accountants, Financial Crime Analysts, IT experts and admin staff. Co-located with the Bureau are the Criminal Assets Section of the Chief State Solicitor's Office, who provide all our solicitor services. But our dedication, loyalty and hard work has been the bedrock of the Bureau's achievements to date. And this is why today's auction is one of such significance and illustrates perfectly the Bureau's statutory remit, which is to deny and deprive. In the past 2 months, the Criminal Assets Bureau has successfully sold 12 properties, 30 high-value vehicles, and are today auctioning off a further 100 authenticated high-value items, starting at 1 o'clock. This auction is due to run until 1 p.m. next Monday afternoon, the 4th of December 2023. This is what's referred to as a timed online auction. I've been advised that there have been in excess of 350,000 hits on the webpage for this auction alone, with global interest registered from as far away as New Zealand, the US, all across Europe and from Ireland itself. And the link to this auction is available through our social media platforms. The items being auctioned today include 46 watches, assorted jewellery and a variety of designer goods. They all range in value from 400 to 40,000 euro. The Bureau targets criminals and criminal organisations of all shapes and sizes within communities regardless of their location. These targets continue to flaunt their criminally acquired wealth through the purchase of items like those that are in today's auction. Our actions are aided by various contributions, including over 600 locally trained divisional asset profilers, which are the Bureau's eyes and ears in the community. In 22, 105 asset profiles were received from our divisional asset profilers throughout Ireland, and ongoing contact and close cooperation was maintained both regionally and divisionally. The Bureau also relies heavily on information received by members of the public on a regular basis. These good citizens' reports come in the form of handwritten and typed letters, email messages, and messages received privately through our Facebook page or by telephone calls. To date, in 23, so the Bureau has received 222 good citizens' reports. And we'd like to take this opportunity to thank those citizens for communicating with us. The Bureau currently has 1,475 targets, 23 of which reside outside the state. Approximately half of the targets on our books reside within the Dublin metropolitan region, and the remainder reside throughout the state. It's worth noting that during the Bureau's infancy, the types of assets seized were cash, money in bank accounts, jewellery and property. Today, however, the Bureau's targets continue to flaunt their criminally acquired wealth through the purchase of luxury design goods such as handbags, clothing, watches and jewellery. They also live a lavish lifestyle that goes beyond their legitimate means. All monies collected under the statutory remit of the Criminal Assets Bureau are forwarded to the Central Fund, the disbursement of which is controlled by the Central Exchequer. This is in accordance with existing legislation in this area. The good news is that the money we take from selling these houses, cars and high-value goods can make its way back to the community via the new initiative which supports investment in community safety projects under the Department of Justice. We do need to be mindful, however, especially on a day like today, when we look through the catalogue of seized items which have successfully made it to auction, that in acquiring some of these assets, criminals have created victims and used fear and intimidation to pursue their life of crime and leave behind them a trail of destruction which impacts the community. The Criminal Assets Bureau's statutory functions are to identify and investigate proceeds of criminal conduct and to take appropriate actions under law to deny and deprive persons of the benefits of assets that are the proceeds of crime by freezing, preserving and confiscating these assets. The sale of these high-value assets today are an illustration of the correct and appropriate actions that resulted in denying and depriving people of the proceeds of crime. The net proceeds of these items will be returned to the Exchequer. Thank you.